Hello and welcome to another Houdini tutorial. This is regarding part 3 of Houdini's online tutorials for Houdini foundations, and so this is working with a rubber toy. And right now we are on part 3, adding color and switching to a Teapot. So as you can see, we've got a rubber toy from our last session. Nothing much has changed there. And so what we're going to want to do is we're just going to want to add some color. So you can see that we've got our tree over here. So in between our points from volume and copy to points, let's add some color. So that's all step one. So search for color. Drop in between these two notes. Let's change that color to red and make it stand out a little bit more. And then we can click on the render region tool to make some bounds. We'll click render first, so that our computer knows which geometry it's working with, and then we can draw a box and see what it looks like. So let's draw a box, and you can see that we've rendered it just fine, no problem, but our red isn't showing up, and that's because we need a material bound to the actual geometry we're using before any color will show up within a render. So let's click out for now, and let's move on to step two. So I'm gonna press tab, and type in material network. That's what we're looking for, so enter, and we're just gonna place that up top for now and go to the material palette. Within the material palette, we wanna find our object. So there are two single bricks, single brick original and single brick one. We're working on single brick one for these videos, so we're gonna open that up, and we're just gonna drag a principled shader in here. Now we're gonna click on that principled shader, and we're gonna rename it into brick underscore mat. And set that. Now we can move on to step three by going back to our geometry. As you can see, we've added that principal shader. So let's go back to our actual network by clicking on the back button right here. Now we're gonna go to our copy to points node down here. We're gonna right click, and we're gonna look for material. And we're just gonna place that node down there. I'm gonna select the node, display its flag. So that's what we're viewing, and we're gonna go right over here to operator chooser next to material, click on it, and we're looking for single brick one. We know we have a mat net, and there's our brick dot mat or brick underscore mat, and we're gonna export relative path and accept. So let's press the render button again so we can apply those changes, and then we'll draw another boundary box and see if anything has changed regarding the color. All right, that might still be an old render, so let's hit the render button one more time to make sure it's doing everything right. And it does appear to be doing everything right, but there's still no color. Well, let's move on to step four, and we'll see if maybe there's anything else that goes on. So we're gonna go back to our material palette, and we're gonna select our brick material. Now we're going to go to surfaces, which is already open right here, and we're gonna change our base color to 0.5. 0.5 and 0.5. And then we're gonna tell it to use that path color. So now we're actually instructing it to use the color that's set to it. Now, if we render again to save those changes, wait a couple seconds. Now we're gonna draw another boundary box. Still white. Let's render again. Now let's see if anything has changed. Okay, and you can see very slowly as my computer is rendering it. Okay, and now it's all there. So we can see that our toy is now fully red. It's not showing the entire toy. I don't know why my rendering's off center like this, but we know that it's at least the color we want it to be. So now we can save our work and move on to step five. All right, let's go back to our geometry network. Press the back button again, and let's get to our select tool by pressing S. Now within our network, we're gonna press tab and look for a switch. We have a switch right there, and we're gonna place it down, spacebar H to view our entire network, and we're just gonna drop it right in between our test geometry and our match size nodes. Now, we're gonna go on to step six. We can go to the create panel, which is right up here, and we can drag down a Platonic solids node. So in this part of the tutorial, they explain that tools can be dragged into the network view as long as the node sense makes type, or as long as the node, as long as the node makes sense, you know. So we're working with Platonic solids here, and Platonic solids are applied to geometry, the geometry context and objects. So we can just drag it down from here and plop it right there. And so now that we put it in here, we're going to change this solid type. We're going to change that to a Utah teapot, and we're going to set its radius to 4.2. So now you can see there's a shadow of teapot down there. If we actually display it, you can see that the whole teapot is there, but we're going to go right back down here to materials to display that. All right, now in step 7, we're going to connect the output of the Platonic node to the input of our switch. And if we go to the switch and change the input to 1, you can now see that we have essentially, quote unquote, cubified a teapot shape. And what's cool about this is that if we add another Platonic solid, and let's say we change this one to a dodecahedron, and let's have let it have a radius of 3.0, right? If we now feed this into our switch and change our value to 2, you can see that we've got a dodecahedron completely cubified. No need to redo it, no need to make another project and start over from the top. Houdini is a procedural language that allows us to take some pieces out and put some pieces in. And as long as it has the proper context, that's why some nodes take more inputs and have more outputs. As long as each node in the system has the correct context, being that it has the correct parent node and is feeding to the right child, then everything should work just fine. So, going on to step 8, we're just going to go back to our switch node. We're just going to set it to 0 to get back to our toy. And then we're just going to want to spacebar H to look at our toy. And to turn off our select tool, we can just go to the viewport. And or we can just go to the network and click in the network, and that'll turn off our select tool. And so now we can go back and forth between any of the shapes that we have. We're just going to save for now. And that's going to be the end of this one. So I'd like to thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.